Hey guys, it's Aubrey with MikeShreve.com. Just going to do a quick run through with you on how to open and edit these graphic files in Adobe Photoshop. It should be noted I'm using a Mac, but it doesn't matter whether you're using a Mac or a PC, the process is similar. So go ahead and open this up in Photoshop. You'll notice that you get this little error message that comes up. It's okay. All that means is that your fonts that are in the graphic aren't the same as the ones that are on your computer. Totally fine. You can just hit OK. And your graphic will pop up. You probably noticed I'm using Photoshop CS6. It doesn't matter what version you're using. This is a very similar process no matter where you are in Photoshop. Whether it's Elements or any of the versions, you should be OK. So right away, you'll notice that we have a generic company name, some filler text, and a blank phone number. We're going to want to change that so that it is more accurate to what you want for your particular banner that you're creating. So if this was my project, first thing that I would do is open up these little drop-down menus here so that I can change the text. Anything with that warning just means that that's a piece of text that is missing as far as you don't have that font. So let's start with the company name. We're going to select that layer right there, and then we're going to select our text tool and we're going to click on it. It's telling us we don't have that font. Totally okay. Changes it to one I don't like, so we're going to switch it to Rockwell Extra Bold because that works. Okay, so that's selected. The font is changed, and we are going to, if this was my project, I'm going to name it. Oops. Sorry about that. If this is my project, I'm going to name it Main Street Dental. So we have that changed. The next one we're going to work on is this filler text here. That is located in this layer. We're going to click it, bring our text tool back over here. And we're going to put in the address for this one. So we're going to say that we're at 123 Southwest Main Street. Going to be in any town in Kentucky. That's where we're going to be today. And then you're going to want to put your zip code here. So we're going to do that for our zip code. You could, even if you wanted to, if you really wanted to shake things up, you could put, say this is cosmetic dentistry. You really have a lot of flexibility in this area. You can really do whatever you want there. You could have, if you have a specific phrase that you like to carry in your advertising, you could say, affordability, quality, reliability, family and cosmetic dentistry. You could put your address. You could put a whole lot of things here. But you're gonna wanna put something there. But basically in here you can just sort of play around with it and have it say whatever you'd like. So moving down to the next layer we're going to work on, that's going to be the phone number. You'll find that here. We're going to select it with our text tool. There goes that warning again. It's totally fine. I'm going to change that to an 800 number today if this was my dental office. Very original number, I know. So that is the gist of it. You can also change this to that other font to match above if you want to. Whatever font you want, that's your own choice. But that is essentially how we do it. And you have a banner all ready to go. If you want to turn this into a JPEG, that is important as well. What you're going to want to do is go up to the layer menu at the top. You'll want to hit layer, flatten image, discard any hidden layers. You now have a flat image, and you can save it as whatever you would like to, and hit OK, and you're good to go.